last two online lecture, we learned the chemical kinetics of second order reaction. In first lecture, we learned the chemical kinetics of second order reaction involving single reactant. We derived the integrated rate equation for the second order reaction involving the single reactant. In second lecture, we learned the chemical kinetics of second order reaction involving two reactants with equal initial concentration. We derived the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactants with equal initial concentration. The integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving single reactant and integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactants with equal initial concentration are the same. In these two cases, integrated rate equation K2 is equal to x upon A into T A minus x. This is the integrated rate equation for the second order reaction involving single reactor and the second order reaction involving two reactor with equal initial concentration. Reaction involving single reactor and reaction involving two reactor with equal initial concentration. In these two cases, the integrated rate equation for the second order reaction is the same, and this equation is K2 is equal to x upon A into T A minus x. In today's lecture, we discuss the chemical kinetics of second order reaction. The case second, the reaction involving two reactor with unequal initial concentration. In this lecture, we derive integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactor with unequal initial concentration. Then consider the reaction and how to derive the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactor with unequal initial concentration. Then consider the general reaction A plus B. It gives product. This reaction involves two reactants, the reactant A and B. These two reactants react to give the product. Then consider if CA is concentration of reactant A, CB is concentration of reactant B, then by law of mass action, if CA and CB, these are the concentration of reactant A and B respectively, then by using law of mass action, we can write the rate equation for this reaction. For this second order reaction, the rate equation is equal to the rate of reaction is defined as decreasing concentration of reactant with respect to time. There is two reactants are involved. The rate of reaction expressed by either decreasing concentration of reactant A or decreasing concentration of reactant B with time. If reaction involves two reactants, the rate of reaction expressed by decreasing concentration of reactant, any one reactant, with time. We can express the rate of reaction either decreasing concentration of reactant A minus dCA upon dt or decreasing concentration of reactant B minus dCB upon dt. And according to law of mass action, this rate of reaction is directly proportional to concentration of reactant A and concentration of reactant B. Then we express the rate of reaction minus dCA upon dt. In this equation, we introduce the viscosity constant K2 into concentration of reactant A into concentration of reactant B. There is a two reactants are involved, then we express the rate of reaction of decreasing concentration of any one reactant minus dCB dCA upon dt is equal to K2 CA into CB. This is the equation 1. This is the differential form of rate equation. In this differential form of rate equation, the exponent of the reactant in the rate equation, the reactant A and B are involved, their concentration are involved, CA and CB. The exponent of the concentration of reactant A and B is 1, 1. The overall order of reaction is 1 plus 1, 2. It is a second order reaction. Minus dCA upon dt is equal to K2 CA into CB. This is the rate equation for the second order reaction involving two reactants. Minus dCA upon dt is equal to K2 CA into CB. Then consider if A mole, the small A mole is, the small A mole is concentration of reactant A. The small A mole is the concentration of reactant A at a time T. The small A mole is the concentration of reactant A. It is the initial concentration. The small A mole is the initial concentration of reactant A at a time T. Small B mole is the initial concentration of reactant B at a time T. The small RB is the initial concentration of reactant B at a time T. We discussed the conditions, such case second, the reaction involves two reactants with unequal initial concentration. The initial concentration of reactant A is a small a mole, and initial concentration of reactant B is small b mole. A mole is the initial concentration of reactant A at time T. B mole is the initial concentration of reactant B at time T. If X mole, after some time, X mole is reactive. X mole is a reactive concentration of A and B at a time T. The X mole is a reactive concentration. After some time, X mole is the reactive concentration. Out of the initial concentration A and B, some of the concentration is reactive. This reactive concentration is X mole at a time T. Then A minus X is unreactive concentration. A minus X is unreactive concentration of A at a time T. And B minus X is unreactive. B minus X is unreactive concentration of B at time T. If A is the initial concentration of reactant A, X is the reactive concentration of A, then A minus X is unreactive concentration of reactant A. B is the initial concentration of reactant B. X is a reactive concentration, then B minus X is unreactive concentration of reactant B. Then CA is equal to A minus X. The rate of reaction is a depends on the concentration of reactant at that time. Means rate of reaction is depends on unreacted concentration. At which time we can measure the rate of reaction? At that time, rate of reaction depends on unreacted concentration. represent the CA is equal to A minus X and CB is equal to A minus, this CB is equal to B minus thing. We can represent CA is equal to A minus X and CB is equal to B minus X. Then substitute the value CA and CB in equation 1. We can substitute CA is equal to A minus X and CB is equal to B minus X in equation 1. Then equation 1 becomes, we can substitute CA is equal to A minus X minus D into CA is equal to A minus X upon DT is equal to K2. Then we can substitute CA is equal to A minus X and CB is equal to B minus X. Then we can solve this minus D into A minus DA upon DX minus DA upon DX minus into minus plus D into X DX upon DT is equal to K2 A minus X into B minus X minus D into A minus DA upon which is DT minus DA upon DT then minus D into minus X plus DX upon DT is equal to K2 A minus X B minus X. The derivative of constant is 0 minus DA upon DT becomes is equal to 0. Then this equation becomes, then this equation we can write dx upon dt is equal to dx upon dt is equal to k2 a minus x into k2 a minus x into the b minus x. Dx upon dt is equal to k2 a minus x into b minus x. Then separating variables, then we can write this equation dx upon a minus x into b minus x is equal to k2 dt. Dx upon a minus x into b minus x is equal to k2 dt. Then we can write this k2 dt is equal to dx upon a minus x into b minus x. This is the equation number 2. You can write this equation in this form only. The k2 dt is equal to dx upon a minus x into b minus x. This is the equation 2. We derive the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactors with an equal initial concentration. To derive this integrated rate equation, for this case, reaction involving two reactors with an equal initial concentration, we consider this reaction. The reaction involves two reactors A and B, reduced product. If CA and CB, these are the concentration of reactant A and B at a time T, then by using law of mass action, we can write the rate equation minus dCA upon dt is equal to minus dCB upon dt is directly proportional to concentration of reactant A into concentration of reactant B. We introduce the proportionality constant in this equation. Minus dCA upon dt is equal to K2CA into CB. If A mole is the initial concentration of reactant A, we consider A mole is the initial concentration of reactant A at a time T. B mole is the initial concentration of reactant B at a time T. If after some time some of the concentration as reaction proceeds, some initial concentration is reacted of both reactant, X mole is reacted concentration of reactant A and B at a time T, then A minus minus X is an unreactive concentration of reactant A. B minus X is an unreactive concentration of reactant B at a time T. Then we can substitute. The rate of reaction is depends on unreacted concentration. The concentration, we can measure the rate at that time. At that time, what is the concentration of reactant? At that time, unreacted concentration Ca is equal to A minus X and Cb is equal to B minus X. We can substitute Ca is equal to A minus X and Cb is equal to B minus X in equation 1. Then substituting this, the equation 1 becomes minus D A minus X upon dt K to A minus X B minus X divided by, then we can solve this, minus D upon dt becomes 0, it is a constant. Then dx upon dt minus d into a minus x dx plus dx upon dt k to a minus x b minus x. This equation becomes dx upon dt is equal to this k to a minus x b minus x. Then separating variables, we can write this equation dx upon a minus x b minus x is equal to k2 dt. Then k2 dt is equal to a dx upon a minus x b minus x. So the equation 2. Then consider, integrate the equation 2. Then we integrate this equation 2 by using method of partial fraction. This is the method of, by using the method of partial fraction, we integrate the equation 2 between the limits then consider, this is the equation number 2, k2 dt is equal to, the k2 dt is equal to dx upon a minus x b minus x. This is the equation number 2. Then integrate this equation by the method of integration partial fraction. Integrating equation 2 by partial fraction method. Integrate the equation 2 by method of partial fraction. Then what? How to integrate this equation by partial fraction? Consider this right hand side term of the equation. The dx upon a minus x into b minus x. This is the right hand side of the equation. Dx upon a minus x b minus x. This can be, we can write in this way. A minus b. This is, we can write in this form. Dx upon a minus x b minus x. This can be write in this way. 1 upon a minus b in bracket dx upon b minus x minus dx upon a minus x. The left hand side and right hand side are equal. We can solve this. The left hand side and right hand side of the equation are same. Both equations are same. This dx upon a minus x b minus x, by the partial fraction we can write in this way. This side and this side, left hand side and right hand side are equal. Dx upon a minus x b minus x is equal to 1 upon a minus b dx upon b minus x minus dx upon a minus x. Then in this equation 2, dx upon a minus x b minus x we can write in this way. Dx upon a minus x b minus x we can write 1 upon a minus b dx upon b minus x minus dx upon a minus x. Then consider, the k2 dt is equal to, we can write dx a minus x b minus x is equal to 1 upon a minus b
bracket dx b minus x minus dx upon a minus x. This is the equation number 3. Then integrate this equation 3. Integrating equation 3 between limits. Integrate the equation 3 between limits. T is equal to 0 to t is equal to t for time. For time we can integrate the equation 3. T is equal to 0 to t is equal to t for time. And x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x for concentration x. Then we can integrate the equation 3 between the limit t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t for time. X is equal to 0 to x is equal to x for the concentration. Then we integrate this k2 dt. T is equal to 0 to t is equal to 0. We integrate this equation 3 between limit. This k2 is a constant, then you can write this. The k2 integrate dt is equal to 1 upon a minus b. It is also constant term. Then integrating this, x is equal to 0. This x is equal to x to x is equal to 0. Integrating this right hand side, dx upon b minus x minus dx upon b minus x. Then we can integrate this equation 3 between limit t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t, and for concentration x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x. Then we can write this way, k2 t is equal to 0 t is equal to t dt is equal to 1 upon a minus b. The integration x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x dx upon b minus x minus integration of x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x dx upon b minus x. Then the integration of dt is a t. K2 we can write t is equal to t and t is equal to 0 is equal to 1 upon a minus b. The integration of dx upon b minus x is ln b minus x. The integration of dx upon b minus x is minus ln b minus x. This x is equal to x to x is equal to 0 minus integration of dx upon, it is a minus x, dx upon a minus x. It has integration again. The integration of dx upon a minus x is a minus ln b a minus x. Integration limits x is equal to 0, x is equal to x. Then substituting the value of integration, k2 t is equal to 2 and t is equal to 0, t minus 0 is equal to 1 upon a minus b, 1 upon a minus b. Then we can substitute the integration minus ln. Consider this minus ln b x is equal to x. We can substitute x is equal to x. Minus into minus it becomes plus ln b x is equal to 0.
we can substitute the integration ln v minus x is equal to x, minus into minus becomes plus ln b, this is the minus and then it minus, then minus minus becomes the plus. We can write this, it is a minus into minus ln b x is equal to 0, then minus ln a minus x is equal to x, we can substitute x is equal to the x into minus ln this become, we can write minus ln a minus x minus into minus ln a x is equal to 0, then we can write this by substituting the integration limits. Then we can obtain k2 t is equal to 1 upon a minus b minus ln, then consider this minus ln b minus x, minus into minus plus ln b. Then it becomes again minus into minus plus ln a minus x. Then minus into minus plus ln a minus x. Before solve this, consider this minus minus ln a minus x, minus into minus plus ln a. Then this is the equation 2 we can obtain. Then integrating equation 2 by the method of partial fraction. Integrate the equation 2 by method of partial fraction. The right hand side of the equation dx upon a minus x b minus x we can write in this way. This left hand side and right hand side of the equation are same. The dx upon a minus x b minus x by partial fraction method we can write 1 upon a minus b dx upon b minus x minus dx upon a minus x. We can solve this, we get this. If we solve this right hand side, we get the left hand side dx upon a minus x. Dx upon a minus x into b minus x. Then we can substitute dx upon a minus x b minus x is equal to 1 upon a minus b dx upon b minus x dx upon a minus x. Then we can substitute this k2 dt is equal to 1 upon a minus b dx b minus x minus dx upon a minus x. Then integrate this equation 3 between the limits for time t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t and for concentration x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x. Then integrate this equation 2, the k2 dt times 0 to t, 1 upon a minus b is a constant. Then integration of this right hand side, x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x, dx upon b minus x, dx upon, it becomes a minus x, dx upon a minus x. Then we can integrate this k2, integration of dt is a t is equal to 0, t is equal to t. The integration of dx upon b minus x is ln b minus x. And integration of dx upon a minus x is ln a minus x. We substitute the integration limit k to t is equal to t minus t is equal to 0. 1 upon a minus b ln b minus x, x is equal to x minus minus ln, the minus ln then we can substitute minus x is equal to 0 and x is equal to x minus ln b minus x is equal to 0. Similarly minus ln minus ln a minus x is equal to x minus into minus ln a minus x is equal to 0. Then we can solve the t minus 0 is a t, k to t is equal to 1 upon a minus b. Ln minus ln b minus x minus into minus plus ln b minus this minus ln a minus x is minus into minus plus ln a. Then we can solve again this k2 dt is equal to 1 upon a minus b minus ln b minus x ln b. It becomes minus into minus plus ln a minus x, and this minus into, you can write minus into plus minus ln a. Then we can write this k2 dt is equal to 1 upon a minus x. K2 dt is equal to 1 upon a minus x. We can write this in this way. Ln a minus x, this is the plus ln a minus x plus ln b. The ln a minus x plus ln b, we can write this ln b minus x is minus ln b minus x. We take the minus sign outside the bracket, then minus into ln b minus x, it becomes ln b minus x. This ln a is a minus, then we can take it is a plus, minus into plus ln a. Then consider this, we can write, we can rearrange this equation, ln plus ln a minus x plus ln b minus ln b minus x. We can take the plus ln b minus x, plus minus it become minus ln b minus x. The ln a is a minus, we can take plus, minus into plus, it is minus ln a. Then we can write this equation, okay, consider, then we can write this equation in this form using the rules of logarithm. K2t is equal to 1 upon a minus b, 1 upon a minus b. The ln a minus x plus ln b, we can write ln b a minus x using the rules of logarithm. The ln a minus x plus ln b, similar to the ln a plus ln b, we can write ln a into b. Similarly, ln a minus x into ln b, we can write ln b into a minus x. Then similarly, minus, this is the minus term, ln b minus x plus, this is the first, ln b into a minus x. Then consider this equation, ln b minus x plus ln a. We can write ln a into b minus x. Ln b into a minus x, ln a into b minus x. Then consider again, ln a minus ln b. We can write ln a upon b. The ln a plus ln b, consider we can take this is the a and this is the b. Then this equation becomes k2t is equal to 1 upon a minus b ln b a minus x divided by a into b minus x. Then we can write using the rules of logarithm, ln a minus ln b is equal to ln a upon b. And similarly, we can write ln b into a minus x upon ln a into minus x, and this is the integrated wave equation for the second order reaction involving two reactors with unequal concentration. Then changing the log to the base state, you can change the log to the base state. The equation becomes K2T is equal to 2.303 A minus B. Ln, this ln becomes log to the base 10, B A minus X into A B minus X. Then K2 is equal to 2.303 A minus B into T log B into A minus X divided by A into B minus X. This is the integrated rate equation. This is equation number 4. And this equation number 4 is an integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactors with unequal initial concentration. K2 is equal to 2.303 A minus B into T log B into A minus X, A into B minus X. This is the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactors with unequal initial concentration. The integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactors with unequal initial concentration, K2 is equal to 2.303 A minus B into T log B into A minus X, A into B minus X. Then we derive the integrated rate equation for the second order reaction for two different cases. The case first, reaction involving single reactor. In this case, integrated rate equation is, in this case, the integrated rate equation is K2 is equal to X upon A into T A minus X. The reaction involving the single reactor, second order reaction. And in the case second, reaction involves two reactors. In this case, there is a two sub cases. The sub case first, reaction involves two reactors with equal initial concentration. In this case, rate equation is same as reaction involving single reactor. K2 is equal to X upon A into T A minus X. And this is the sub case second, reaction involving two reactors. In this case, integrated rate equation K2 is equal to 2.303 A minus B into T log B into A minus X, A upon A into B minus X. In next lecture, we'll learn the characteristic for second order reaction. The graphical representation means nature of graph, half-life period, and unit of